Dragon's Teen on Demand.
Okay, that's right. We were staring at each other. Me and that lovely pizza. Thank you, Colgate, for reminding me. Oh god, there's another one. They're just all over the place over here. Slenderman 2.0. I don't know where else to really go through here either. I guess I'll just walk back. Just backtrack. Sean being Sean Bean. This is the Whomping Willow. It leads to the Shrieking Shack. Am I Harry Pottering right? Get it swinging directly in your face. Well, see, all that's there. All that's there. All I need is the cam. That's what I was saying, Tortoise. I don't like the big, giant, fluffy foam thing. I don't want to put it on. Maybe if I step back a little bit from the microphone, my alliteration won't be so obvious. I don't know. Let's take a look at the map again. See, I think all this stuff got... Yeah, I've got two more things to kind of discover on this map. Let's try and reach... 54 degrees north, 61 degrees east. 54 degrees north, 61 degrees east. I guess I should... I don't want to do that, though. If I ran back to this, I could warp over. I could warp over. But I feel like I'm kind of in this area anyways. So, I guess... Let's keep walking. Hi, Shumley. You were right, I've peed my pants a couple of times already. Would you feel kind of like a sellout if you got a cam at this point? No. But only because I can't see myself doing that. I'm actually kind of... I have an odd sense of pride of having built up the channel without using a cam. And not just that, just kind of... I've had some people tell me that somehow my silly shit has influenced them to not use a cam, and I'm like, yes! One of us! So, that's cool. That's always cool. You're triggered. Chad, I don't know. We haven't really discussed what's going on. I'm not necessarily opposed to doing it, but I think if she asked, if she could do it, she wouldn't use the camera either. So, But I think when camera casters take it away, people miss that element, so they get trapped. What are my thoughts on people who use cams? I don't really have any thoughts. You do you is my thought. Some people need that because they're better able to connect with people with body language, facial expressions and whatnot. And that's, I think it's fine. I don't know. Go this way. Who needs a cam when we can use your face as an emote? Yeah, that's true. That's true. I mean, I go to cons. People have met me. I'm not impressive. Am I gonna watch the UFC pay-per-view tomorrow? What is... Who's on the card? I don't know who's on the card. Make a... I thought about that too, Chad. I thought about that too. We'll talk about it soon. I will ask. I think they're going out of town soon. I think this weekend or something. I don't know. I don't know their life. I don't think you are improving a stream because I can see you are. Yeah. It really depends on the person. Like I said, some people emote more with their facial expressions and all that stuff. There were a lot of reasons that I just decided not to use a cam, and it's worked out great for me, so I'm lucky that I was able to make it work, to carry a broadcast with just the power of my stupid voice. That's awesome. IMHO. I don't really know where I'm going. I mean, I know where I'm going, but I don't. I hear you, paper. I hear the paper! I'm paper chasing. Literally paper chasing! Alive corpses on Siberia. Was there a top secret facility where scientists worked on reviving the dead? Have you guys ever seen Dead Snow? Several elements would suggest that this is the case. We are in Inia, a town in Siberia. Here there was supposed to be the institute where decades ago the most brilliant minds were to accomplish the impossible, revive corpses. Nowadays, in place of the complex, there are only ruins. It is difficult to determine what exactly was there. Till this day, we can stumble upon things resembling medical equipment, but it is clear there was no hospital here. As the elder locals recall, one day the military came, marked out an area, set up a construction site, and it took them several years to build it, one building after another. People were happy because there was work, but as soon as they finished, the military surrounded the area with barbed wire fences and forbade to even walk in the vicinity. I remember trucks pulling up and soldiers unloading some equipment. Behind there was a large lot where huge delivery vehicles pulled up. People said those were refrigerated trucks. It had been going on like that for more than... Do you really need refrigerated trucks in Siberia? Something to think about. It had been going on like that for more than a dozen years and nothing happened. Two or three years before they closed it down, some weird things had occurred. We saw them transporting people to the facility, and the whole village heard screaming in the middle of the night, as if they were murdering people. One day it just stopped. The trucks left. The military stayed for a while. Engineers came. They tore the whole thing to the ground, and that was it. What could have been in that facility? When asked about a possible explanation, Dr. Ligiev, an eminent historian, says, "It was not unusual for the previous government to build a facility hidden deep in the corners of Siberia. It does not have to have anything to do with any paranormal fairy tale, but merely with classified military activity." Although historical sources remain silent about any village and any military facilities or scientists in this area, it totally contradicts the inhabitants' stories. What is a boob noise? Yeah, what is a boob noise? Could you elaborate on that? I'm thinking of 40-year-old virgin where he's like, "It felt like a bag of sand." And they're like, "A bag of sand? Have you ever touched a boob?" We became aware of existing documents that could shed light on the case. An extract from a correspondence where the names of the sender and receiver are censored mentions about a facility in the middle of Siberia where the military sends well-preserved bodies of convicts and refrigerator trucks for further research. Furthermore, the author writes, "I do hope you will manage to do something with them because the mountain is becoming impatient and one alive is not enough." Boob noises. Do I stream in the dark? I don't. Because I value my eyesight. And that would just kill my eyes. What's up, Cosby? How's it going? I'm still Sean Bean, in case you were wondering. I came down here. Okay, I did. I came down here. I'm gonna think about this. I'm gonna get back to you on like the sound of boobs, and we'll see if we can't somehow conceptualize that together as a group. This doesn't seem right. I'd like to find a coordinate. Motherfucking Sean Bean. Good night, OV. And yeah, what Colgate said. Follow OV. Congratulate him as he is advanced in balls of steel. Follow him. This has got to be right. This has got to be right. Bras make noises. I guess. I don't know. Oh, excuse me. I don't know what that would be either. This looks like where I started. Okay. I can dig this. I can work with this. If this is, in fact, where I started. Because then I can kind of pinpoint, like, the next... I have two coordinates on the map that I haven't visited yet. And I can kind of... I can warp to the closest area. Although I'm kind of enjoying not warping. It's been a little more realistic to not warp back and forth. That's really graphic, Sir Silver. That is very graphic. Yep, this is the beginning. This is back where I started. Excuse me. That was a yawn. My fire is out. I guess that doesn't... Well, it kind of matters. Okay, so the two coordinates that I haven't reached yet are... Let's see, 54 degrees north, 61 degrees east. 54 is 61. So the closest thing is going to be here. I think I'm okay with warping back and forth just because it's going to take a lot of wandering around just to even find some of these things. It's these parts that you could actually fall asleep. Is it the ASMR? Let me tell you about a couple days ago, Coyote Brown, 6 months of support. Thank you so much. Everybody say sup to Coyote Brown. Thank you for your continued patronage. Or wait. It's, I think, what is it that I say in the YouTube thing? Thank you for supporting the Church of Skin Tea. Hey, I think I've got it. I think I've got it. It's my YouTube like end thing. YouTube end. Open with this.
Do not forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more of this fuckball douche nonsense on a regular basis. Thank you for supporting the Church of Skin Teen. We appreciate your patronage.
I should just do that part, I suppose. Although, welcome back to the Church of Skin Teen. That lady's... She's boss, too. Okay, so yeah. The ASMR work things. This is what happened 2 days ago. So, Colgate. Our very own Colgate. Several days ago was talking about the Star Trek it was like the Enterprise engine idling for like 10 hours video. So I showed it to Lorg, and Lorg finds one that's like in 1080p audio and it's 12 hours long. So I put that on. And then I found this, like, mechanical keyboarding, like, this mechanical keyboard typing loop. It's only, like, a 12-minute video, but I put it in YouTube Looper. And I put those on, like, real faintly in the background, and I got so much work done yesterday. Oh, my God. I felt like an ASMR wizard. ASMR is like some kind of weird hipster shit. I don't know. Ovi and I like to find weird ASMR. Did I? I literally just walked down a hill. Let's go this way. To maximize the experience, I also put on DEFCON Radio from Soma FM. I'm gonna say it again. 1080p audio. So many pixels in your audio. I could start Mass Effect too. Could start Mass Effect. Well, no, I can't. I don't have it installed yet. Maybe I'll do that when I get off cast. I'd like to start playing the Mass Effect trilogy again. I gotta find coordinates. Main. You just play bad dubstep when you want to get a bunch of work done. I have to have something ambient because sometimes I'm working on audio and I actually have to like listen. And with music in the background, I can't focus on that. So ASMR is some kind of audio sensory muscle relaxation. I don't know what the... I can't remember what the acronym is, but people describe it as this tingling sensation you get from certain audio cues, if you will. Hey, Aussie Yak, how's it going? Scrubbers League! Have I played Dungeons and Dragons? Not really. I've never done like a lot of actual tabletop roleplay. I always kind of wanted to like get involved with the group or something, but I don't have the time. I just don't have the time. But it would be up my alley. Just in terms of fantasy. High fantasy stuff. Paper Bag used to do a lot of that. It looks like a hand. I know it's not. It looks like a hand. I guess we'll walk up this way. Autonomous sensory meridian response. Okay, thank you, Morbid. Thank you. Touching a horcrux again. Scruffy the janitor. I think I'm two like points on the map from finishing this game. That is my guess that I have to find all this crap. But I don't, without finding like a waypoint on the map or some kind of coordinates, I'm just kind of roaming around looking for stuff. Which is fine. It's perfectly fine. There are times where there's stuff in this game that makes me think of Torchlight. Like audio from Torchlight. There's this little ding noise that I keep hearing that reminds me of Torchlight. This is an 18 and older stream. Coyote can say that. That's... I mean, it's too much information, but it's within his rights to say it. Does that ting trigger my... No. No, it doesn't. It just makes me want to play Torchlight. I've sunk a lot of time into both those games. The first one and the second one. I played a lot of the first one on Xbox, actually. I thought that was a really well done... port. All things considered. Okay, there's a coordinate. It's right here. Here we go. 27 North, 52 East. Which is nowhere near where we need to be. We need to go to 54 North and 61 East. I would consider it checkers. I've played Torchlight 2 on Steam. I've played a lot of Torchlight 2 on Steam. That was one of the games that I would just kind of turn on and start playing on cast before I knew what I was doing. If you consider what I'm doing now to be knowing what I'm doing. Way to go, Joey. You fucked it up. That is back where we started. There's the hand mountain. High five mountain. I'm just gonna walk back this way. I'm doing very well whether I know what I'm doing or not. Well, thank you. I mean, I'm having fun, which I think is the important part. That is what is important. If you're not having fun, you're just doing Twitch entirely wrong. I think it's this way. The wolves, I'm surprised it's like the long dark. I haven't run into any wolves that have just not completely eaten me. Just keep hearing them. So we found that the note the one note that just said,
we are sitting.
No.
We are sit-
no. This. Caution, a psychopath is on the loose. I'm wondering if Anton, who I think is Sean Bean, isn't the psychopath. And there's just some crazy shit going on up here. Or if the game is just trying to lead me in like several different like what if directions on what happened to these students or whatever. Because the whole point of this game kind of is... I don't know that we're specifically investigating, but unofficially, as per what we're doing in the game, we're kind of investigating what's going on. Like, what happened to these students that were on this mountain that just mysteriously disappeared back in, like, the 50s or something. No regrets. I'm glad, Osiak. I'm glad. I didn't catch what you said because the mods are quick. Oh, excuse me. Again. I'm gonna be on a lot tonight. I feel like there was a coordinate around here. I would like to find something to indicate where I am on the map. So I can... be a little less directionless. I'm gonna come up this way. Tommy. You have no Tommy pickles. I see what you did there, Aussie. It's clever. It's clever. You have no Chucky Finsters. I don't either. This, I think, is where I kind of ran through. So maybe there's something that I can discover through here. Like, I ran through here because fire people, magic people, voodoo people. What the fuck is that? Is that a piece of paper? Is it a shiny rock? For a second there, I thought it was Sean Bean. There was something there. There was more than just what I'm reasonably sure. Let me come back. Y- Yeah, from here it totally looks like a person. It's just the light. Good night, Stella. Good night, Indiana. Thank you for the raid again. Everybody please follow Indiana. She's the type of dude. I think she does kind of a lot of survival type games. If I'm not mistaken. I hear paper. It's up there somewhere. Yeah, I'm gonna make sure Stella's channel is or her Etsy store is kind of linked up in the next week, so that the plushies are if anybody wants a plushie, they can order one. I've overshot the whole thing. I want the paper. It's back there. Yeah, she's going to do a couple of emote plushies, and then there's a potential for other stuff that is related to the channel in the future. Getting like way lost.
Eons.
Oh.
That's how long I spent suspended in nothingness. And then this one time, a pale, dim glow filled it. I felt as if some consciousness started soaking through an orange cloud into my brain, dripping with heavy drops, not letting me pass away nice and peaceful. I fought with myself. I had no strength to open my eyes. And finally, after processing this situation on and on, I realized I have no eyes.
He was doing a blind playthrough. No, it's Sean Bean in The Slender Man. So I must be going in a right direction for the voiceover to trigger. Paper. Pacific Space, anything to enrich your time on the internet, which for me is the bread and butter of this channel. Okay, there's... This is the fire I am at right now. So I am still pretty far... I'm still pretty far from...
Base guy.
Anything that I need. Matt Berrar with the 5 months of support. Thank you so much. Thank you for never leaving my internet cult. Please say sup in the chat to Mad Bear Rar. I do recognize this. I have been here before. Hey, Lucky Louie, how's it going? The Izdal woman. Have I ever played Path of Exile or Diablo 3? Diablo. I like to call it Diablo, just to be an ass. I played both of those, Scott the Human. I actually thought about getting back in the Path of Exile. And Diablo is a game that, I've played a lot, too. I'll still play it from time to time, but... I haven't touched it in several months. They don't respect people. What are you talking about, Chatty? What are you talking about? Places. You're definitely a cool person. I respect your decision to remain subscribed to Skinteen. Well, Matt Bear makes me a lot of motivational posters and is the one person who consistently reminds me that I need to be assertive and tell these enemies in all these games just like a firm no. Which, that's like important. That's important. Everybody should be educated on the power of the word no. Not just to say it, but to listen to it. Somebody says no, don't fucking do that thing. It's not a coy, fun way to say yes, I'm being coy. It means no. I need coordinates. That's right. Tell them no. Firmly, sternly. No. Like you would reprimand like a dog. Seems to me I'm not at all going in the right direction. Yeah. That's correct. Just pretend no never means yes. Wanna There we go. Well, okay, so I'm by the Whomping Willow again. This isn't quite where I want to be. You're about 7 episodes in. How far? I finished the whole thing. I started at like 8 o'clock last night, 9 o'clock. I think it was 9 o'clock. And I finished at 10 o'clock this morning. Or technically yesterday morning. I finished at 10 o'clock in the morning. Then I had to call somebody for work. So this email. And she answers the phone. She says, "How you doing?" And I kind of laughed and I said, "Here's the thing. The new season of Orange is the New Black got released early last night." And she went, "Oh, cool." And I said, "I just finished it about 20 minutes ago." And she laughed at me. The nervous laugh of a person who knew they had to work with me today. But I did fine. It seems to me... Okay, let's go this way. Just kind of jog out of here. All Falls, it's cool so far. It's kind of frustrating to get a little lost in it, but it's not terrible because it looks so nice. Let's just walk straight back this way. And I think once it's clear to me, it's evident that I'm going to be doing this for a bit longer, so... Once I finish this game, we're probably done for the night. Not as long of a stream as I would intend on going to the length of tonight. Unless it takes me forever to finish this, which it could. It could. This could turn into another fiasco. Another Deadly Premonition fiasco. Jesus Christ, I hope not. And then we'll be back tomorrow with something else. No spoilers, the episode where the flashback to the Chinese leader with the subtitles going way too fast with it. That could have been just you. I've noticed if I watch Netflix on certain devices, the subtitles will just kind of lag. I shoot video. It's part of my job. That's what I had to do today. I had to shoot videos. Luckily, it was a relaxed work day. And I work at home, so it's not difficult. Freelancy stuff. If I was in the woods, wouldn't I get lost too? Yes. I'm actually kind of... After all, like... Movies like The Blair Witch Project, the woods actually kind of terrify me. The woods are lovely, dark, and deep. I have promises to keep and many miles. Has the chat UI thing been in the hole? Yes, it has. I think this goes back. Yeah, this should go back to the general area I want to be in. I gotta make some highlights from that Deadly Premonition stream. Specifically the fishing and the 45 minutes of trying to get that game to end. It was fun. I had a blast on Sunday. Excuse me, I kind of messed up my whole week of sleep, but it was worth it. It was worth it. You know the feeling of fear at night. Ugh, man, that would just... Ugh. Good night, is it Somi? Somi? I've seen you in here pretty much the whole night. But thanks for hanging out. I should be back tomorrow. The new game. Haven't decided what yet. Oh my god, HJ Tenchi. With the 6 months of support, say sup to Tenchi. Thank you for hanging out in my weird internet cult and supporting it for as long as you have. Everybody should follow him. He's pretty rad. HJ Tenchi. How's it going, Tenchi? I'm lost. I'm me, Dana Scully, medical doctor, lost in the woods with Sean Bean, the voice inside my head. A thing did get done. A thing got done. While I'm roaming around trying to think of things to talk about, of which I have many, in a few weeks, specifically the weekend of the 12th? The 12th is my one-year stream anniversary. I will have officially been streaming on Twitch for a year. That weekend, which I think the Saturday is the 11th, it's like the 10th or the 11th, I think... Either then or the weekend after. We'll see if I've got stuff going on. But I'm going to do another, like, Doomcast. 12 hours minimum. And we'll probably start a bit earlier. Because once we start getting into that stretch of time where it's like 10 o'clock in the morning. And that's my 12-hour mark. I actually start to feel terrible. but yeah, I think we'll do 12 hours. I will at least commit to 12 hours of streaming. Doom! Probably Doom 2. I'll get the details out. It's going to be that weekend of... So maybe the 11th. And maybe the weekend after. But that'll be my one-year stream anniversary. ACOG, I think the 12th is a Sunday, so it's probably going to be, like, the 10th or the 11th. So the Friday or Saturday right before. And if I have things going on that weekend, then I'm gonna push it, like, a week. But I should be good. I should be good for it. Happy birthday, Twitch Skin Teen channel thing. Thank you. I've actually had the channel for... several years. I just didn't start using it for broadcasting until the 12th. Playing Paper Sorcerer. 69 degrees north. How is that game? 69 degrees north. 71 degrees east. And I need to find 66, 66 and 72. I'm really close to whatever I need to find over here. I'm really close. Brutal Doom. we may do the Brutal Doom. We may just do Brutal Doom instead of just like vanilla or chocolate doom or what have you. I've got to get my Doom stuff reset up. I got the new broadcast PC. Or the cast. I have a new setup, more or less. I hear paper. I think this is where I heard the paper before. It's right there. It's getting really dark. Okay.
The weather today clearly got worse, just as our moods. We're all a little scared of what happened last night. There were even some suggestions of going back, but that was outvoted.
Good night, Lucky Louie.
We set off at around 10 a.m., going the same Mansi trail as we did earlier. We encountered a small camp of a local hunter during our hike. We asked if he had hunted the other night, but he said no. He told us a story about a ghost prowling through the forest in the form of a bright fog.
We saw that.
Obviously, this did not make us feel better. We kept on going forward. Today, the hike was slow and difficult. The visibility is close to zero. The temperature dropped to minus 24 centigrade. Around 4 p.m., we had to start looking for a place to set up a camp. We found a good spot on the verge of the forest, covered from the wind. As exhausted as we were, we began setting it up. We were too tired to dig up a hole for the campfire. We ate dinner in our tents. We had no strength for any discussions or thoughts. At night, I clearly heard someone walking around the tent. I heard
them
whispering my name. I do not want to talk about it with the rest of the group. They'll think I'm going crazy.
That's pretty freaky. Okay, it's just insanely dark up here. Is this a cave entrance? No, it's just getting darker. Jesus Christ. This is... Oh, man. The gothy side of me is freaking out. The other side of me is just... like, anxious. Oh my god, I see a thing. I see a thing roaming around in there. I can't do it. We gotta go back! Now it's light over there! Look at that! I see the foggy thing, I think. No? Maybe not. Looks like a person. Now it's getting dark again! We're gonna have to run through here. We're gonna have to straight up run through here. Let's just do it. Let's just go. Fuck. Oh, fuck. I fell in a hole. Here we go. I don't even know what happened there. I just fell in a hole and died. Dude, Bloodborne was awesome. This game is all about being anxious because of the... Let's just do it. Let's just run through. Who gives a fuck? Bring it on, buddy. Fucking A! There's traps everywhere in the ground. All right. Let's just... Again? Cheeto dust! Okay, let's try and look at the ground and see if I can maybe if we can Spotify some of these areas. Running through. Fuck off. I can't. I'm stuck. I'm gonna get trapped by the boogeyman. Oh God. This is a house. There's a house up there, you guys. Oh shit! Not again. Okay, gotta run. Do I have time to just read this with the boogeyman after me? An entry from the testimony of Boris W., a 5-year-old boy possibly exposed to the unknown force that caused the death of 12 people at the Vladimir 30 complex. Boris W., I've seen you in my dream. You asked me about the same thing you are asking about right now. The same man was standing behind you. Dr. Grigor Antanowicz. Boris, there's no one standing behind me. No one's here. Boris, you're wrong, Dr. Grigor Antanowicz. You are wrong, Dr. Grigor Antanowicz. This man is asking me to tell you that in the orange light, the world is more beautiful, and asks you to take a look at chamber number 7 in section 22. Doctor, how do you know all this, Boris? Are you fucking kidding me? I'm reading! God damn it. I gotta run through all that again. Or do I? Where the shit am I? Okay, the house is up here. I see it. Fucking A. There's that. I think I collected the note. Yeah, I did. But I just need to keep moving. I just need to keep moving so I can read it. I hear paper again. Paper!
We set off quite late today. I think everyone heard something at night, but they are afraid to admit it. I walked around the tents, but didn't notice any tracks. We didn't talk too much. We barely hiked 2.5 miles. We got the impression that something clearly changed around us. I felt someone was observing us, and I think the others had a similar feeling because they mentioned the hunter was heading in the same direction. We won't make it any further. I think we'll stay here.
Okay, can I... Do I have time?
We are sitting in room...
To look at the note with the kid. Okay, here we go. There it is. No, okay. How do you know all this, Boris? Did your father work in our department? No, Grigor, you son of a bitch. I've seen with my own eyes. This is 7. He's like, no, Grigor, you son of a bitch. Son of a bitch. I've seen it with my own eyes. I've seen you taking people to God's eye. I've seen their skin burning and their arms being twisted. I've seen the nightmares that it planted in their brains. Do you honestly think no one knows about this? Do you think nobody survived? He has shown us. End of the entry. Okay, I feel like I have to get the shit out of here. I'm not... This is giving me anxiety, just because it's dark and it's the woods. Like, I'm actually nervous about this. You know how some people can't play, like an underwater game? Me in the woods. Me in the frickin' frackin' woods. Like, this dark scene here, this is terrifying. This is a fear that I never entirely realized that I had until right now. Hey, we're in a spot. Let me look. Did I find... I feel like I gotta get back to that house. That house looked like a significant thing. Welcome back, Wooji. That house, there's something significant about that house, but jeepers creepers. 60 degrees north, 66 degrees east. 60 degrees north, 66 degrees east. It's that house has got to be the next, like, marker. Because I'm pretty much right above it. In a sense. On the map. I'm going to have to go back. Yeah, Jubilee, it's... We've entered a world of darkness. Yo, man. Fuck the one. I want to get, like, a game like that just to see if I have that kind of, like, kind of a phobia. The woods I'm not too surprised about because I used to be in the Girl Scouts and we went camping and I've been in the woods. Like, the woods generally are kind of creepy. Like, in this dark... Like, just pitch black with trees. It's terrifying. It's utterly terrifying. Good night, checkers! Oh, fuck! I see a thing. I see the guy. I see the Slender Man. He's like, you can't come back in here. Don't you think about coming back in here? Jesus Christ.
I used to be in the Girl Scout and we went camping, but the woods, though, they are kinda creepy.
Thanks for reiterating that shit. Colgate. We're running. Fucking running. That's... You dick. You dick. Thank you, Colgate, for the $5. Was that in fact what it was? play Amnesia. I have played Amnesia. I finished Amnesia. That was a fun time, Amnesia. I haven't done a Machine for Pigs, but I did The Dark Descent. That was actually, I played that on Halloween. Could we just... Like, I have an idea. When I see him, I'm just gonna run at him. I'm just gonna bum rush him. Let's just see what happens. I need to get to that house. I want to get back to the house. This is the wrong way. Let's go back up and around, I suppose. I temporarily turned the bot sounds down just to, so I didn't get pulled out of the atmosphere of the game too much. I'm so sorry. I'm so very sorry. The horn, all the sounds will be back. They haven't gone anywhere. I've just turned the volume down completely. Paper. Confidential correspondence of Section 22 scientists. Doctor named Confidential. Dr. Colgate. I tested subject number ACOG Muffin. They did not show any supernatural skills. You had to make a mistake. Sincerely, Dr. Full of Cake. Dr. Chattywacker, I agree with you. The second test did not show any skills. We may deem the experiment concluded and unsuccessful. The subject should be removed. We will prepare transport to Vladimir 30. Please destroy all documentation and correspondence. Sincerely, Dr. Scrabble's League. Normally I'm not opposed to it, but at the beginning of this game, I took kind of a vote about whether or not I should temporarily just disable the sounds. And most people said yes. So we went for it. Rage Badger, you can be whatever you put your mind to. So what? My mother always said, there's some shit over there. That's the house. That's the house I want to get to. I fucking hate it over here. Let's try and get to this house. 67 degrees north, 70 degrees east. That house has got to be the next marker, but in order to get to it, I'm having some... Oh, here we go. This means I'm going the right way. Usually. Shit! Motherfucker! Can I please get to the bridge? There's like a bridge. That fucking thing is right behind me. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. Such anxiety. I don't know how to get back. I'm gonna run into fucking Freak Man. Cause he's just chilling over here. Waiting. Like, boo. What is with my frame rate? That was weird. Oh yeah, ACOG, I've got the first few lines of chat covered up, like maybe the first 10 or so. Seems to be a method that works well for me. There's a bridge! I saw the flamey person! Motherfucker. This is... I'm kind of lost from where... Not United based. Thanks for hanging out tonight. I think I might take a quick break. I was halfway expecting to die.
She told me I could become anything, so I became a tip.
Thank you, Rage Badger, for the $2. Show some love in the chats. Pretty breeze. Okay, I see why I'm dying now. It's not just a hole. There's a bridge to get to that house, and I can't.
Do not forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more of this fuckball douche nonsense on a regular basis. Thank you for supporting the Church of Skin Team. We appreciate your patronage.